After graduating with a degree in electrical engineering, Brad Morton built his career path in Evansville. But becoming a father led him to take an unexpected risk, starting his own solar company in 2006.
I have three children, three girls, and I'm constantly thinking, do I want to raise my kids in an area where they're going to have almost a twice as likely chance of getting cancer, you know, because we do live in a very poor air quality region. And it was a desire to make a difference. Solar can be part of the answer there. It's not the whole complete answer, but it's part of the formula.
Thanks to increased industry competition in recent years, solar systems have become dramatically cheaper, and advances in technology have made it easier to set up small-scale systems, utilizing microinverters, which convert direct current from a single solar panel to alternating current on the electrical grid.
Solar energy systems are much more efficient when they are tied to the grid. You don't require batteries. When you have to charge a battery and discharge it, you lose about 15% of the power. So with a grid-tied solar energy system, it works at 100% of its capabilities. And all of that energy is being utilized somewhere.
Morton estimates that an average family home would need 32 panels to produce as much energy as they need for a year, something the industry calls net zero. If they produce more than they need, residents can earn credits, an incentive that has led to groundbreaking projects for Morton, including work on the country's first net zero school, Richardsville Elementary, located outside of Bowling Green, Kentucky.
There is a 210 kilowatt system on the roof, and then there is a 140 kilowatt system in the parking lot on a solar parking canopy. And that's enough to power about 40 to 50 homes. The school board got a check for $37,000 from the utility company down there, and they want to do it on every school now. They have taken this to heart, and they are energy experts.
And right here in Indiana, Morton helped build the country's first net zero library in the small town of Chrisney, thanks to a grant from the Office of Community and Rural Affairs and the incredible fundraising efforts of its residents.
We knew that this library needed to be energy efficient, and we had to make sure that was cost effective. Our population is less than 500, and so we really had to educate them on what this was. And they really took this project on and they supported us. They donated, even if it was just a brick. So it's unbelievable. We've tracked it for years. We have a credit every month for energy. So to me, it's just unbelievable that, again, we took this leap of faith, hoping that it would work. And to be pioneers for something so amazing, we feel very proud.
And for Brad, his mission is to bring that type of success to homeowners across the Midwest, making renewable energy affordable to anyone who wants it.
Most homeowners don't realize they see the price tag of $20,000 as a high number, but in reality, they're going to pay five times that amount to their utility company in the next 20 years. It's really a no-brainer in my mind, and it's just a matter of getting that word out and making people understand that.
That's precisely what happened with Gary Shultz. After being interested in solar energy for decades, when he learned that he could pay off a system in just 10 years, he made the investment.
More and more, it seems overwhelmingly that there's evidence that we're affecting the environment. So it just seemed like something small that I can do. So we've produced as much as we've used over the whole winter. The other day, we hit zero again, and it's kind of embarrassing, but I kind of get a kick out of watching the meter go backwards. And every day I look over there and I can see the smokestacks, and there's always something coming out of them. So to know that I'm doing a little bit to reduce that, it's a good feeling.
And for Brad, those smokestacks have been his biggest challenge. Indiana is one of the only states without a mandate requiring utility companies to obtain a percentage of their energy from renewable resources. Only two companies, both located in Indianapolis, have introduced such incentives for their customers.
They both have been highly successful. Last year, there were 960 solar jobs created in Indiana. Between the environment, the economics, and the jobs, it's a revenue generation from the clear blue sky. I mean, I don't see how you can get any better product for your home than that, you know. In my mind, it is about saving the planet. You know, that's really the big driving force behind it.